morning. So in this video class, we understand the another experiment, profile projector. Okay. So the aim is to measure different screw thread parameter for a given specimen using profile projector. Okay. So here we have to measure a different screw thread parameter. So we have taken specimen as a screw thread. For that screw thread, we have to go for in order to measure a different parameter like root, crest, helix angle, pitch, major diameter, minor diameter, pitch, depth of the thread. Like these are the dimensions you can found on the specimen. So for that specimen, if you go for measurement, it is very difficult. So for that, we have a special device. We say profile projector. So in that profile projector, we are going to use the specimen as a screw thread. Okay. For that screw thread, here we have to go for the different dimensions by using this particular device. Okay. It's nothing but what? A profile projector. With that, we can able to find out different parameter for the given specimen. So coming to the tools required: profile projector, screw thread element, okay, and magnifying lens. These are the tools required for this particular experiment. Coming to the observation, the least count of the protractor, that is, we got 2 minutes. You can see here the 2 minutes. So this is what main scale division with the minimum value, that is 1 degree, and the coincide vernier division is 30. So for this 60 minutes divided by 30, we got 2 minutes. That is the least count for the protractor. Coming to the least count of the micrometer, so that is 0.01 mm, that is main scale division is 0.5 mm, that is the least value, and coincide vernier division is the 50 mm, that is what we are going to get the value is 0.01 mm for the micrometer. So again, I am repeating here, protractor is 2 minutes and the least count of the micrometer is 0.01 mm. Coming to the tabular column. So in the tabular column, it is very simple and you can easily understand. So serial number, screw thread element. So I have already mentioned about the screw thread, what are the dimensions you can find and what are the elements what you can find here: the major diameter, the minor diameter, pitch and depth of thread. Okay. So these are the elements we need to find out by using profile projector. Okay. So this is about the a simple concept with respect to the profile projector. Yes, look at the figure. This is a simple screw thread. So first of all, I list the what are the elements in the screw thread. Okay, so this is what I have magnified the lens, or we can say the screw thread. This is the magnified view. So the points, the parts are, or we can say the elements of this particular screw thread are, this is the root, this is the crest, and here you can see the dotted lines. Okay, so for this, here we call it is a helix angle, and this consecutive two thread screw roots are there, no? It is nothing but what? Pitch, and these are the external threads. We call it is a external threads. Internal threads are different. Okay, and this is the thread angle. This form is there, no? This form we call it is a thread angle. This is what a simple screw thread magnified view. When you say about the thread, a thread is a continuous helical ridge formed on the inside or outside of a cylinder. Okay, let us take it. This is a considered a cylinder. For this, here you can see the condition of the whatever the ridge you are going to form. This is what we are going to form on the external surface. We call it is a external thread. When you say about the internal thread, whatever the cylinder inside what you are going to make, that is the internal threads. Now we are going to discuss about the external threads. When you say external thread, a thread is a continuous helical ridge formed on the inside or outside of a cylinder. As you already know, what do you mean by cylinder? The ridge is called the crest. This ridge is there, no? We call it is a ridge. It is called crest. Between each crest is a space is called root. Okay. Between each crest is called, we call it is a root. Threads are set an angle of the axis of the bolt. So you can see here, let us take an imaginary line, we call it is an axis. The dotted line we call it is an axis. Here
threads are set at angle of to the axis of the bolt. So for example, this is a cylinder, this is assumed to be an axis line. So the angles are set for this particular bolt, or we can say nut. This slope is called a helix angle. So this is what we can see, some kind of slope is there with respect to axis line, that is nothing but what? Helix angle. The thread shape formed, okay, the thread forms a V shape between the crest. So here you can see the V shape, that is nothing but what? The thread forms a V shape between the crest. Between the crest, it is nothing but what? Formation about the shape, which is nothing but what? Thread angle, or we can say V shape. This angle of this V is called the thread angle. So it is mentioned here, this is a thread angle. So this is what? A simple concept with respect to the screw thread. So one more part is, I have missed here. So one is the minor diameter and one is the major diameter. When you say about the major diameter, from this point to this point, it is nothing but what? Major diameter. When coming to the minor diameter, from this portion to this portion, this point is nothing but what? A minor diameter. That we have to understand, and it is very much important. Okay, so it is nothing but what? Minor diameter and major diameter. I will explain once again. From this point to this point, okay, this length is called, is there, it is nothing but what? Minor diameter. When coming to the major diameter, this portion, from this portion to this portion, like I have mentioned here, dotted line, you can see here, this is, I have mentioned major diameter and this is the minor diameter. When coming to the developed column, here what are the elements are there? For this element, by using profile projector, we have to find out the each element. For example, we have to measure the major diameter. So in the major diameter, we have an initial reading and final reading. And similarly, CVD, we have an initial reading and final reading. And for this, we have a total reading, that is MSR, the CVD into LC, that is in the unit is mm, that there we have to write about the initial reading and final reading. And finally, we have to write the value of the element in mm. So first thing, by using profile projector, for this particular element, we have to take the value, that is the initial reading. For the initial reading, by the usage of profile projector, you know already the least count of the profile projector and as well as the least count of the micrometer. By using this, first we have to go for finding the major diameter, that initial reading. So after found initial reading, we have to write the value in the initial reading for the MSR. And similarly, the initial reading of the CVD value. So here we have to calculate the total reading. How we are going to calculate? MSR plus CVD into LC. LC for the least count. What is their LC? That is what? For the micrometer, that is 0.01 mm. So that whatever you are going to get the values, you are going to write the initial reading for the total reading. So after calculating the value, you are going to get the final reading. The difference you are going to get, that is the total value of the element. So similarly, minor diameter, the same process, pitch, the same process, and the depth of thread, we can going to conduct the same process. It is going to be continued. So we will go for the conduction of the experiment. So thereby you are understanding the how you are going to use this profile projector and how you have to take the values you are going to learn in detail. Okay, right. Okay. So this is measurement of screw thread element using a profile projector. In the profile projector, here we have a screen, okay, and this is the table. In the table, we have the movement of the vernier caliper, that is the micrometer. This can be moved horizontally and this can be moved vertically. Here we have a diagonal lines, okay. So this is the magnifying lens, and this is, we have a table, or we can say the component, or we can say the specimen can be easily placed on the table. Okay. So for this, here we have a lighting system. There you can see that whatever the thread angle, or we can say the picture, can be clearly visible. So if sufficient light is not there, you are unable to define what are the elements on the screw thread, or we can say a component of the specimen. So this is plays a very important role in order to find the minor diameter, major diameter, and the depth, the crest or helix angle. You can easily find out by using this particular device. So first of all, before starting of the experiment, first you have to clean the parts with respect to the cleaning of this particular table, the movement of the table, and least count. First you have to check the error with respect to the vernier or micrometer. Similarly for the y-axis, that whatever the micrometers are there, you need to check the any zero error. First of all, you have to clean the components very cleanly, and we have to take the specimen. That is, here you can see the specimen. This is the external threaded component, or we can say the specimen, the bolt. Okay, so for this so if it is for the normal eyes here, it is very difficult to calculate the major diameter, and you can easily find out the major diameter and minor diameter. What about the pitch? What about the angle? It is very difficult. So for this, here we have to go for using the profile projector. This easily can be identified. What are the depth, what are the thread angle, what are the crest, you can easily find out by using this particular device. Okay, just I am going to place the specimen on the table. You can easily understand. See here in the screen, here you can easily identify how this can be enlarged. See here, I am going to place the specimen here, and I am going to adjust. Okay. Here you can easily identify, you can easily see that the minor diameter and the major diameter. Okay, so here from this point to this point, this is minor diameter. From this point to this point, this is a major diameter. So in the before conduction of this experiment, it is very difficult to calculate the values. Okay, so by using this profile projector, you can easily define, you can easily see that the different element on this particular equipment. So we are using a profile projector in order to find the different elements. Now the movement of this particular, you can here along with the screen, we have a x-axis line. This is very thin line. Okay, here you can see the x-axis line. The movement of the pen, here you can see this is the x-axis line and this is the y-axis line. It is a reference line. Okay, so if these reference lines are there, you can easily find out the what are the elements by using this particular device. Okay, see here, I am going to adjust in such a way that x-axis line, okay, is correctly coinciding with the imaginary line of the screw. See here, the moment for this particular x-axis, the linear moment. See here, slight moment. I am going to adjust the x-axis line for this particular. It is moving upward from this point to this point. Here, see here. Adjusting with the help of micrometer. When I rotate this, the movement of the diagram you can easily understand. Now it is moving downwards. This is with reference to the x-axis. Okay, now coming to the vertical line, by using that micrometer, here you can see it is rotating. No, see here the moment, it is moving towards left side. So from this point to this point, it is moving. Okay, so this is about the adjustment of the micrometer by using profile projector. So listen here. Now this axis line, okay, is exactly pointing on the screw, it is showing the correct value. Okay, simultaneously after adjusting this, you have to note down the value by the this vernier micrometer. So here you can see here the divisions on the main scale and the CVD S. Here I will calculate the value. First, initially we have a 0, okay, then counting of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, okay, then we have a 0.9. So this is MSD is exactly 9, okay, and the CVD we have to count. So 30, 35, 36, 37, okay, exactly it is going to show the value 35, 36, 37. So CVD is the 37 and the main scale is 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 is the main scale and CVD is the 37. So that value you have to write down in the tabular column. So we got main scale division, that is on micrometer, we got the value, that is after calculating the value is 9, CVD is 37, you have calculated, no? And the least count of the micrometer is 0.01, that is 9.37 mm is the main scale, we can say the major diameter. The same value I have written in the tabular column. See here, screw thread element, for the major diameter we are going to find out, no? So for this, main scale reading is 9, CVD is 37, so total reading I have calculated like MSR plus CVD into LC. MSR is the 9, CVD is the 37, least count is the 0.01 for the micrometer. The values are, initial reading is 9.37 and similarly for the final reading, okay? And whatever the values you are going to write, you are going to get that values you have to write down in the tabular column for the main scale reading, for the final reading, CVD for the final, and similarly total reading you have to go for the getting the value with the final value. Okay, so this is what the dimensions for obtained by the profile projector in order to determine the major diameter of the specimen. See here, this is what the reference point for this major diameter, the values we found 9.37 mm. Now we have to move the another reference line. That means this point is going to be moved in such a way that line is coinciding with this particular screws. See here, it is moving upward now. Yes, it is touching the x-axis line. Okay, so for this I need to take the values for this reference line is on the micrometer. See here, the movement of the screw thread from one portion to another portion, the value it is going to indicate, that is 15, 16, 17, 18. 18 is the main scale reading and CVD is exactly after 0 we have completed. There we have showing the value 5. It is exactly lining with the 6, in between 0 and 5 and 6. Okay, so we go for taking the value 6. So main scale division is the 18 and CVD is the 6. So for the second value, we got the value from the main scale division, that is the 18, CVD is 6 and least count is 0.01, that is we got the final value, that is the 18.06 mm, okay, that value is I am going to write in the tabular. So here in the main scale reading, final value is 18, CVD is, final reading is 6 and final reading for the total reading is 18.6 mm, okay. So different the difference what you are going to get, that is the value of the element in mm. That is, I am going to subtract the final reading minus initial reading in order to get the total value 18.6 minus 9.37. If you subtract the value, what you are going to get, that is the total value for the element, that is in order to get the unities of this particular element is mm. So after differentiating, what you are going to get, that is the major diameter. So see here, the value of the element, that is total value, is 9.23. after subtracting the total reading, that is the final reading minus initial reading, the final reading is 18.6 and the initial reading is 9.37. so if you subtract, the 9.23 mm is the total value for the major diameter. So the major diameter is the value is 9.23 for the specimen. Like, you are going to calculate the major diameter, that is what you have calculated from this reference point to this reference point. So if you calculate by using profile projector, you are going to get the value is 9.23 mm, that is a major diameter. Here, this is what we have calculated for the major diameter. Now we have to go for to determine the minor diameter. See, the movement of the screw, or we can say, if you rotate this, okay, here see the movement downward in order to calculate the minor diameter. Okay, you have to adjust the line, this x-axis line here, exactly coinciding this particular point. Okay, see here. Okay, so in order to determine the minor diameter for this particular position, here we have to see the dimensions, or we can say the values on the corresponding micrometer. See here, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, 10. It is almost all coinciding on the line. Main scale division is 10, and the CVD is, we have completed 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, and 35. So main scale division is 10, and CVD is the 35. So these values I have to write down in the tabular column. So here, for the minor diameter, I got the value, initial reading is 10, because of the movement of the micrometer in order to obtain the value. So I got initial reading for the minor diameter is 10, that is, I have written in the initial reading, that is the 10, and for the CVD is 35. After calculating the formula, we got the total reading, that is MSR plus CVD into LC, we got 10.35. okay, so this is about the initial reading. So after taking this value, that is 10 and as well as 35 on the CVD, 10 is the main scale division, now we have to move the line. Okay, now it is moving upward. Now we have to adjust the line in such a way that from this point to this point, this line is going to coincide with this particular point. Okay, by rotating this micrometer. See here, the moment. Okay, it is exactly coinciding. Okay, so for this, corresponding values are noted by using micrometer. Yes, 15 is completed, 16, 17. So main scale division is 17. Okay, now CVD we have to calculate. CVD we have completed 40, 41, 42, 45 also completed. In between 45 and 46, we'll take 46. Okay, so 17 main scale division and 46 is the CVD. Okay. Okay, sir. I'm going to write the values in the minor diameter. That is, final reading is 17 mm and the CVD is the 46. Okay, so total reading, how we are going to calculate, means MSR plus CVD into LC, 17, okay, plus 46 into 0.01. if you calculate, the value is 17.46. if you subtract the initial final reading and the initial reading, okay, that is 17.46 minus 10.35, you will get the value, that is 7.11. I am going to write here. Next thing, Appa, picture, E line.
picture.
ಮೋರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಡಣ ಡಬಲ್ ಥ್ರೆಡ್ ಬೇಕಾಗಿದೆ
ನೋಡೋಣ ನೋಡೋಣ ಪಿಚ್ ಅಂದ ಮಾಡೋಣ
ರೈಟ್ ಸರ್ ಪಿಚ್ಚಿಂಗ್
ಇದೆ ಸರ್
ವೈ ಆಕ್ಸಿಸ್ ಸರ್ ಇದು ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಸ್ ಸರ್ ಇದು
ಕ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ತಗೋಬೇಕಲ್ಲ
ಹ್ಞೂ ಸರ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಗೇಟಿವ್ ಥ್ರೆಡ್ಸ್
ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ
ಈ ಥ್ರೆಡಿಂದ ಈ ಥ್ರೆಡ್ಗೆ ಆರ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ ರೈಟ್ ನೋಡಿ ಸರ್
ಕ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್
ನಾನೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಈ ವೈ ಆಕ್ಸಿಸ್ನ ಅಡ್ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊತೀನಿ ಈ ಒಂದು ಥ್ರೆಡ್ಗೆ
Okay, so for next thing we have to go for understanding about the pitch. Okay, after finding the major diameter and the minor diameter, now we have to adjust. See here the adjustment. In order to, if you rotate this, the moment you are going to adjust in such a way that this y-axis line. Okay, you can see here this y-axis line. I am going to adjust from one crest to another crest, either left or right. See here, this is exactly in between the center line. Okay, this for this particular. Okay, I have to go for note down the value. See here, so I have to take the initial reading. It is not visible clearly. Now it is okay. For this particular thread, okay. So for this corresponding leading, here on the values 5, it is exactly lying on 10 line and the CVD is okay above 6, it is showing 5, 6 and the 7 CVD line. Okay, the values what I have written for the pitch, that is initial reading is 10. So you got the value just by adjusting from one of element with respect to the screw, that is from one screw to another screw. Here we got the value is 10 and the CVD is 6 and total reading for the MSR plus CVD into LC, we got the value 10.06. Okay, that is about the pitch value. You can see here, now I am going to go for the second value, that is it is moving left side. By this adjustment micrometer, okay, this line is for this particular screw. Okay, the values are note down the values 5, 6, 7, 8 and below that here you can see it is coinciding with the main scale division, it is coinciding the another line, that is we are considered as 8.5 and the CVD is 45. We have completed 46, 47, 48, 49. Okay, so 8.5 CVD is 49. So in the tabular column for the final reading for the pitch, that is serial number 3, the final reading is 8.5 mm, CVD is 49. Okay, so we got the CVD is 49 and total reading for the MSR CVD into LC, we got 8.99. okay, so initial reading is 10.06 and final reading is 8.99. the value total reading is for the pitch is 1.07 mm. like this we have to go for finding the different parameter by using profile projector. Okay, so this is about in order to find out the different parameter for the given specimen. So finally here we have the result. Measurement of screw thread element for the given specimen is done by using profile projector. Okay, so these are the different parameter in order to find the profile projector. Okay, see here, in order to calculate the depth of thread, first you have to take the initial reading of the major diameter. Okay, first you take the values and I will explain by using the figure how we are going to measure in depth of thread, calculating about the depth of thread. That is the MSR, that is the 9 value what we have got from major diameter. That value I have to write down in the depth of thread, that is MSR, that is the 9 value. Okay, see here, this value is directly written, and similarly for the initial reading of the major diameter I have written. Okay, and similarly minor diameter values, and similarly for the minor diameter is 35. Okay, so if you calculate MSR plus CVD into LC, I got the value, total value for the depth of thread is 9.37 and the final reading is 10.37. okay, so you are differentiating with the final reading with the initial reading, we got the value 1 mm. So in the figure I can explain here, this is the major diameter now for the specimen what you have done in the profile projector. Okay, this is what in reference, in order to calculate the depth of thread, how we are going to take the value. So this is the initial reading for the major diameter and this is the minor diameter. This is the major diameter and this is the minor diameter. Whatever the readings you are going to get, that write down in the tabular column. Okay, and similarly whatever the final reading for the major diameter and the minor diameter, that write down in the CVD what you are going to get. So finally you are going to calculate the depth of thread, that is the 10.37 from the final reading and the initial reading is 9.37. we are going to get the value for total value for the depth of thread is 1 mm. Okay, so this is about in order to find a different parameter for the given specimen. Here the specimen is screw thread parameter for a given specimen using profile projector. Okay, so this completes your profile projector experiment.